All right, back with assistant coach Tommy Twardecki. Another big win today at home. Mm-hmm. Michigan Tech, apparently one of the best teams in the conference. You guys took it to them, controlled the game for the most part. How were you able to have success in today's game?
We knew Tech is, they're always a good team, and Tech is Tech. And when I say that, they're going to make shots, they're going to space the floor, they're going to play hard, and then defensively they're going to pack it in, and they want to kind of grind it out in the half court. So we knew for us, with the athleticism that we have, the guys that play hard, especially Trey and Elijah today, are just game changers on the defensive end. We started the game in our press like we did to finish the Northern game. We wanted to start with it to control that tempo. So by speeding them up a little bit, then we only had to guard them for 15 to 20 seconds in the half court. So that was really key for us, and I thought our guys did a really good job. And then knowing personnel too, because they've got some guys that are players that are shooters and a couple of guys that are not shooters. So being able to help off of them on drives or post-ups was really big for us.
So, Trey Garrett comes in the first half. The game's kind of going back and forth, make a couple of nice defensive plays. Mm-hmm. The team really starts to take over at that point. Talk about his game today. Some mm-hmm. of the things you don't see in the box score that he was able to provide.
Yeah, Trey just brings that edge to us, and he has one speed, and that's 100 miles an hour, and we love it. And every once in a while, we'll get burned by it. Maybe he'll gamble for a steal and we won't get it, but he makes up for it. I mean, that kid's effort on the floor, guarding their foreman, guarding their point guard, just his length and athleticism and pursuing rebounds. Can't say enough about his motor. We love him.
You guys built a bit of a lead going into halftime, but they come mm-hmm. out there, quick 7-0 run. Mm-hmm. DJ hits that nice, that three-pointer, put you back up six to kind of get you back under control, mm-hmm. back into the game. Talk a little about that, Darnell, and what he was able to provide for you today.
Yes, yeah, yep. Again, DJ's been on this little mini tear, but coming out of halftime, maybe it was our energy was down a little bit. We didn't press, we didn't pick up, so they were able to come down and hit some shots, and their big man, give him credit, he came out and made 5 out of 10 threes. When he hasn't been that type of shooter all season, but we had to make that adjustment, and Tyler, came out and pressured him a little bit more, which was important. But yeah, we knew, a team like that's gonna hit shots, they're gonna make a little mini run, but having seniors like DJ, Ty, James and Deli to just step up and be leaders and be like, all right, they made a couple shots, they're on a little 6-0, 7-0 run, it ends. And we're gonna come down, I'm just gonna get a bucket. I'm gonna do what I do. So yeah, DJ's been doing that, and again, he has, what did he finish with today? 21 points, 7 for 9 from the free throw line, 4 for 7 from 3, so just efficient defensively. He's been locking up guys. He played 38 minutes, didn't look tired at all, so yeah, big time credit to him.
It's nice to have you home for a couple of games.
Yeah.
A little out of the ordinary to actually have you here at in University Center to play.
That's nice.
Heading back on the road next week. Couple of games, one at PNW and then over to Wisconsin Parkside.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about those matchups and how important this next upcoming weekend is going to be for you.
Yeah, yeah. Again, you can throw the records out the board when you're on the road in the GLIAC. I know Purdue is struggling a little bit and Parkside's kind of middle of the pack, but Parkside had these guys beat at Michigan Tech for about 30 minutes, and then Tech took over the last 10. So we know what Parkside's capable of. Purdue is a team that they want to get up and down. They want to have 100 possessions in the game. So that'll be an interesting matchup with our pace as well and our ability to press. So we'll have to watch some more film and things like that. Watch this game, see where we can get better and learn from it. And yeah, get back on the road and go find a way to get two of them.
Thanks, Coach.
Yep, thank you.